The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
Live from Boston, Massachusetts, this is Unscheduled with Les Scimo and the Dave on Armed Radio. And this is Unscheduled, and I want to thank the military all around the world, especially on the border and in the combat theater. Thank you and God bless you. And big thank you to the families for your love and support for our warriors. And you know, they're out there keeping us safe, Dave. And like I said before, we're both proud veterans. Dave is a U.S. Air Force. I was a United States Army. And we appreciate everything. Appreciate everything they're doing. And you still want to do a sound check on that, honey? On your phone there? Yeah, won't you try it? Yeah, you'll be all right right there. And, but anyway, Dave, a lot of things going on right now, and I'm going to get on this abortion thing here in a minute, but I want to hit this real fast. In the spirit of Louis Armstrong, I love the trumpet, love to hear the trumpet played, and, you know, the man really couldn't sing, but he had that unique voice. If you ever heard him sing, you know that was Louis Armstrong. A lot of y'all out there too young to remember him. But in the spirit of Louis Armstrong, I'm going to sing this little bitty note right here. And as he would say, anybody here seen Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg? Can you tell me where she go? Where's she at, David? What's going on here? Is she dead? They stuffing her up?
I haven't heard anything about her. Yeah, I don't know. Last I heard, she had two spots removed from her lungs, and she was recuperating at home. But I haven't heard anything lately.
Been 55 days since she sat on the court. You know, she's done a little bit of work, they say, from home. I read a thing today. They say Nancy Pelosi's doing some cover-up work for her. Which that could be true. You know, they're scared to death of her dying because, you know, that's going to bring up another Supreme Court justice for President Trump to nominate, you know. And so the scuttlebutt is, I can't think of the lady's name. It's going to be a woman. And but there's a lot of mystery surrounding this, you know. And so Fox News, they accidentally put up a flash of the bat phone. Congressman Steve Shabbat. Wrong line, Mr. Shabbat. Well, what was I saying, Dave? Help me out here.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Yeah. I remember that much. but anyway, scuttlebutt is that he's going to nominate this lady, and they're afraid the Roe v. Wade's out the window and all this stuff. But that brings me to this, Dave, and I know you've seen this. Everybody's seen it. And I'm very upset about this. What they've done in New York, now they're trying to get murder legalized in Virginia. And a Democratic delegate up there, representative, Kathy Tran, she was a sponsor of the Repeal Act. And is it? Let me turn me down a little bit or back off the microphone a little bit. And, but anyway, is that better, honey? So anyway, she submitted the repeal act, they called it, and her and the other Democrats is trying to do the same thing in Virginia that they're doing in New York, Dave. They want to kill these babies right up to the birth is what they want to do. And I encourage everybody, go on Facebook. There's a video out there. Find this video that it's been recorded, this hearing, when she introduced this bill to the committee up there in Virginia. And Todd Gilbert, the Republican House Majority Leader, questioned Tran about the bill during a hearing on Monday, and he asked Tran if a woman who has physical signs she is about to give birth, if she could request an abortion of a physician if it impaired her mental health. And she stumbled around, didn't really want to come right out and answer the question to start with. And he said, well, it's obvious that a woman is about to give birth. She has physical signs that she is about to give birth. Will that still be a point at which she could request an abortion if she was so certified? She's dilating, in other words. He asked. Now, this was her lame answer to start with. Mr. Chairman, that would be a decision that the doctor, the physician, and the woman could make at that point, Tran replied. Now, she wanted him to leave that lay right there, but he didn't. He said, I understand that, Gilbert replied. I'm asking you if your bill allows that. Tran replied, my bill would allow that. So what they're saying, David, is they murder that baby. Partial birth abortion is what it is. And it's genocide. It's just outright genocide. And, you know, Planned Parenthood last year, and I've said this before, they have killed 332,757 babies just last year. I think the last show we went over the number one killer in America. I go back, Dave, and I think about all the dictators in the world. Stalin, Hitler, Mao Zedong, even Castro. And it goes on and on and on. Ho Chi Minh. How many innocent people have been murdered by tyrants, and we went to foreign soil, David, to stop that. 6 million Jews killed in Auschwitz and the other German prison camps trying to exterminate the Jews. And here we are, right in America, on this sacred soil, David. It's soaked with blood of innocent babies. And it gets, you know, and it don't stop there. And I'll get into that in a minute. You got something there, Dave?
You know, God says in Proverbs 6, chapter 6, verse 17, he said, he hates those who shed innocent blood. And also in Scripture, it's recorded in Isaiah chapter 59, beginning verse 6. It reads this way, their webs will not become garments, nor will they cover themselves with their works. Their works are works of iniquity, and the act of violence is in their hands. Their feet run to evil, and they make haste to shed innocent blood. Their thoughts are thoughts of iniquity. Wasting and destruction are in their paths. The way of peace they have not known, and there is no justice in their ways. They have made themselves crooked paths. Whoever takes that way shall not know peace. And that's exactly where we are in this country today. They seek to shed innocent blood. They delight in doing it because they don't know any better. It's the devil. There's an organization called the Satanic Temple, and their head guy his name is Lucian Graves. And you know what he said? He said, I'm scared of Mike Pence. He scares me. But you know what he's scared of? He's scared of Mike Pence's authority in God. because he's of the devil.
Absolutely.
And that's why he's afraid of Mike Pence. And it's and this Ralph Northam, Virginia, who's the governor, he said, if a baby is born, the child will be kept comfortable, if he's alive, that is. But this is after a full-term abortion, after 9 months in the womb. And then he goes on to say, it would be resuscitated if he's born dead and the mother and the doctor agree to do so together. But otherwise, we'll let it die. I don't know what they mean by that, if they'll kill it after it's born or before it's born, or they try to kill it as it's being born by poking scissors in it or whatever, trying to snip a spinal cord from the behind at the neck, which a lot of them do to kill the baby before right. It comes out of the birth canal. But this is vulgar. It's obscene. It's infanticide. It's not abortion. It's full-term birth of a baby being born and then killed. I mean, this is unacceptable. And it's only setting us up for euthanasia. And if you don't think euthanasia is going to happen in this country, it's already happened in Europe. Because here's what it says. There's a story I heard about a woman in the Netherlands where they have assisted suicide. Recently, she was diagnosed with a terminal disease, and she signed the paperwork to be killed by lethal injection. And when she reached that point in her condition, they would give her the injection, and after that, she'd be dead. But when it came time, she changed her mind. And she's laying on the stretcher saying, no, I don't want to do this. I would change my mind. But she'd already signed the paperwork. So her family and her doctor and her friends held her down, strapped her to the bed, injected her with the poison, and killed her.
Murder.
Because she'd already signed the paperwork. Yeah. And they didn't think she was in her right mind trying to get out of it. But she said she wanted to live. She didn't want to be killed. She wanted to live.
Right.
How many voices, if those babies could speak, how many would say they want to live?
Absolutely.
They had no choice. They're killed.
Correct.
Because of a woman's selfishness. She could give that baby up for adoption if she doesn't want to keep it.
Right.
She doesn't have to murder it. Two wrongs do not make a right. And killing your infant child is no way for a society to exist. You can't do that. You just can't go around killing precious human life. It's not a thing to do. It's not... I mean, God, there will be, well, Satan's done it before, too.
Oh, yeah, twice.
Remember Moses when he was...
And Jesus.
Yeah, Jesus. He did it twice. He tried to kill all the young babies in order to get rid of Jesus and Moses. So he's just up to... That's why we're at the time when the Lord's coming back, because all these things have happened before. Infanticide. It's happened before and it's happening now. You're seeing it happen right now before your very eyes. The day of the Lord is coming. And he's not going to be pleased when he comes back. He's not coming back as a baby, an infant in a manger. He's coming back as a King of Kings and a Lord of Lords. And those people who don't think so will see him one day. And they're going to be amazed when they see him.
Death is a wrong time to find out that their God's real, David. That's a bad time to find it out, if you're not right with the Lord. But now, murder in no fashion is right. It should never be legal. The Roe v. Wade should have never happened. It was all a sham. It was all based on lies. This is nothing but legalized murder. You can have an abortion in the state of Ohio, but if you hit a pregnant woman and kill her and the baby, you got a double vehicular homicide on your hands there. Our laws is so hypocritical. They're so wrong. We must take a stand. This, and I said this last week, I think. This last March for Life, David, they was over 600-something thousand people estimated. They're the biggest one in history. Now, folks, I'm going to read this. This is very graphic. But now, if you people believe in abortion out there on Facebook, or those that hear me on air around the world, 66 countries, I wish we had translators in every country, Dave, because sometimes we preach the message, a pretty good message. And this first segment here is just a message of life. Dave, and I'm going to say this. When I get on my Facebook and I look at people, all kind of people posting their little babies, their little infants, and one posted some little preemie twins on there that the daddy was holding. I mean, I love seeing those pictures. That's new life to me. That represents new life in our future. I love to see pictures of these little babies. There's nothing that will tug on my heartstrings, Dave, more than a precious. I love little bitty babies. And, you know, they're just so innocent. They're just so precious. And I love to look at these little, this new life, these little babies on there. But I'm going to read, folks, I'm going to read you this. This is what's going on. This is what they pass in New York City, and this is how they do it. And they had a parade somewhere, and I think might have been in New York. I'm not sure, but I've seen the video. They're celebrating abortion, Dave, out in the street. The legislature in New York, they cheered.
Yeah, I remember seeing
when the governor signed this bill. And you know, I'm kind of ticked. Well, I am ticked at the Catholic Church. Kumho's supposed to be a Catholic. They
should be
even
discommunicating. Get him out of the church, I mean.
Absolutely. And they're dragging their feet. They won't do that. But I'm going to read you this. This is how they do it, Dave. This is very graphic, people. But I'm going to read it because we have to know what's going on with these little babies. And I got something else that some of you may not have known. When I read this, but here's how they're going to do it in New York, Dave. The baby is injected with a poison directly into his skull or torso. Then he suffers a hideous, painful death, which he will certainly feel because of his developed nervous system. The mother carries the corpse around in her womb for a day. The next day, there is an ultrasound to check if the baby is dead. If he isn't, if he has been withering and suffering in agony for the past 24 hours, clinging to life, then he will be injected again. The following day, the mother delivers her dead child. Sometimes she delivers him at the clinic, but if she can't make it on time, the clinic is perfectly happy to recommend that she give birth in her toilet. You think about that, folks. If you agree with abortion, with the medical technology, Dave, that we have these days, and you would know this more than I, coming from a medical background, there is very little to no reason for an abortion these days with the medical progress that we've made in this country. And now here's the kicker. In the state of New York, murders, child molesters, mass murders, it's inhumane. It's unconstitutional, New York's constitution, to give a lethal injection to a criminal. But they'll kill a baby. They'll inject that baby, David, inside the mother's womb, or they'll kill it with the partial birth abortion right up to the day that she gives birth. How evil, satanic, and cruel. Folks, those of us that's against abortion, we must speak up against this, David. We must make a stand and come against this, in the name of God, because they don't have a voice, David. I will be their voice. I will stand up against this genocide. Folks, this is America's Holocaust multiplied by several times, David. And a lot of people say, well, how come you're for the death penalty, okay, but you're against abortion? The carnal mind sees a conflict there, but David, even a carnal mind should be able to see plain as day the difference between innocence and guilt. When somebody is put to, given the death sentence, the death penalty, they're not innocent, David.
Well, it's just like when Jesus was on the cross, there was two thieves. One thief looked at him and said, "Why are you here? You've done nothing wrong. We deserve death, but you don't." And this is true. He was innocent, totally innocent, sinless. Right. And that's how he died for our sins, because he was sinless. But we are all, it's true that we're all born into sin, but a child, a baby, is innocent. They don't know. They don't know anything. They're without spot or blemish. You know how you get older, you get, you know, you fall off your bike, or you get cut, or you get your knee scraped while learning to ride your bicycle, and you get a scar. Well, a child comes into this world with no spot or blemish, or no defect. They're perfect. Their skin's perfect. They don't have any marks on them. No moles. No anything. They're perfect. They're without spot or blemish. It's only as we grow older that we get these spots and blemishes. I've got age spots on my hands and on my face, and being out in the sun over the years. But I'm 65 years old. And if anybody would deserve to die, it would be me. But not an innocent child. An innocent child has they have no concept of good or evil. They have nothing. They're but good. And what evil have they done? None. No evil. But yet, we want to take the most innocent of our society and we want to kill them. Whereas, you know, if you're a mass murderer and you've killed 15 people, you deserve to die. You deserve it. I mean, you can be saved, but you deserve death. But a child deserves no death. They deserve every opportunity to live as much as we can provide them. But this is not the way the world sees it. The world sees it exactly opposite than what it should be. If you notice, everything's opposite of the way it should be with the world. Good is bad, and bad is good.
That's what Jesus said.
And that's just where we are right now. Everything is backwards. We kill the innocent and let the guilty go free. And how is that possible? Because the world is all messed up. It doesn't have a concept of right and wrong. And that's where we are today. The world is totally messed up. And this these ideas of passing laws to where this is not abortion. When a baby is full term, 9 months, 40 weeks, whichever you want to say, gestation, that baby's ready to enter into the world. And you want to kill it right then, before it even has a chance to breathe. But this is wrong. This is infanticide. This is killing children. It's not abortion. It's no longer a question of 3 months gestation. This is full term. This is totally, totally wrong. And anybody with half a brain will know this is wrong. You know, this is so wrong that even today's millennials are seeing sonograms of their children when they're being born. And they see how fully developed they are, even at 3-4 months. You can see that, you know, they have hands and fingers, they have feet and toes, they have noses and ears and their head. Everything's developing. It's amazing. But they want to go and kill them at 9 months, full-term baby. And this has to be stopped.
It's off the chart, Dave. I tell you, and it's 4D. Have you seen these 4D ultrasound? Oh. They got a 4D ultrasound, man, and it's just, brother, man, it's spooky. It's so plain. And it's it doesn't look like your X-ray type of 3D. This is in color, and it's amazing. The detail, it shows you the actual baby, David. And
that's a real baby.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Folks, call in here 1-800-508-5431 on Arm Radio. Well, that's SkyMo and the Dave. Now, folks, this is a tough subject, and it's controversial, David, but it should not be controversial.
No controversy. If you believe a person has a right to live,
they got a constitutional right.
What controversy is there? They're just younger than us.
That's right. Yeah.
That's all there is to it. They're just younger than us. Why do you have the right to live when you get old?
Right. Yeah.
You know, they never get a chance to get old. Why is that opportunity afforded to us when you're 2, 3? You take if a mother or father beats their 2 or 3 year old to death and kills them, they go to jail. But you know, they don't serve nearly as much time as somebody that kills a 40-year-old guy or a woman.
Right. That's true.
They don't, especially if you do something else to them. If you rape them and then kill them, you're going to spend the rest of your life in jail. But you can kill a child, and you spend a lot less time in jail.
Months, just months.
It's not right.
Right, right. Well, I'll tell you what. In the same line as this is New Mexico, Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Washington. Now, praise God, the Republicans they have the majority in the House. In the committee, so they're head of the committee. They tabled this bill, David. This bill, as long as they're in the majority, will never see light of day. But folks, I tell you, the evil is just—it's growing worse. It's waxing worse and worse. And Dave, it's just like what you see with the media getting away with the lies. Spreading the lies about these boys. This stuff must be countered with the truth, David. People need to start speaking up. There is no punishment for this stuff. There is no retaliation for this stuff. And the left just continuously gets away with it. And the right has always been known for cowing down and going along to get along. Well, I'm telling you what, folks. You need to start standing up, all of us together. We got to give these babies a voice.
It's a devil that's behind it all.
Pure devil.
I'll tell you what, and the devil's getting more powerful because he's got more people with him. And you know what? Technology is going to take the devil to places he's never been before. But think about this. Only God can know everything that's going on all over the world. He's omnipotent. He's omnipresent, meaning he's everywhere. He's omniscient. He knows everything. But think about this. With the advent of computers and a chip being put in your hand or your forehead, the devil can know every place every human being is in the world. He could never do that before.
Right.
But with computers, with the advent of computers, supercomputers, he could easily know where every person that takes that mark is in the world, whether he's in Asia. He could be in Latin America, South America, Australia. It doesn't matter. Europe, United States, Canada, anywhere in the world. This is why technology is enabling the Antichrist to come soon. Because he's always wanted the power of God. And he's never had it. And he never really ever will have it. But what it does, it gives him a type of power and presence throughout the world because of technology, computers. And this could never be done before. But we're at the time now where it can be done. And this is what you're going to see. Technology, I'll tell you the future. It's going to be fun at first. And then it's going to get dark.
People like to dabble, don't they?
It's going to get dark. And there'll come a day, if the world lasts, you will not be able to drive your car out on the road. You'll have to call for a ride, an Uber ride to come and get you. And there probably won't even be a driver in the car. It'll be wireless, driverless. You just jump in a pod type setup, and it'll take you wherever you need to go. You will not be able to own a car. If you have a car, you won't be able to drive it. What they'll do is they'll make probably you have to haul it to some special area where they allow you to drive it like a racetrack or something. Or if you have a motorcycle, any kind of vehicle.
That's a good thought, Dave.
They will not allow you to drive that on the road because it'd be too dangerous. It'd cause an automobile accident. Everything will be controlled by machines. And we're rapidly approaching that. When this next leap in technology takes place, I don't know how long it's going to be. 2, 3, 4, 5 years, I don't know.
Well, you can see it coming.
It's coming. And the government will take everything you've got, and you'll be at the mercy of the government. That's what they want to do with socialism right now. They want to provide you with insurance. They want to provide you with everything that you need to survive from the government. And that's, and think about this, the devil's behind it.
Well, sure.
Look at the Democrats. Look at their policies. You have gay marriage. You have legalization of drugs. You have all these things that the devil would love for us to go headlong into, because it gives him power. It gives him power over us. The United States isn't the type of country with freedom that the devil likes. The devil likes you in bondage. He likes to control you. He likes to control you in everything you do, whether it's overeating, overdrinking, drug use, pornography.
Anything. They will control you.
He wants to control you. And freedom is the exact antithesis of the Satan's control. And this is where we're heading in the world. It'll be fun at first, but like I said, the technology is going to get darker and darker and darker. And it, control. This is what it's all about, control. And the whole world's going to be under control. And that's because we're not free enough or smart enough to live our own lives the way that we want to. It's the way somebody else dictates.
Well, and you know, and that goes along with our discussion last week. A lot of people live their life without personal responsibility. And you have to have laws, you got to have rules, you got to have do's and don'ts, you got to have cops. David, you got to have a civil society. But for those that are not responsible, you put their butt in jail. It don't matter what it is, if they're a threat to society or innocent people, you can't allow that to run rampant. But now, yeah, you know, you're right. And the Supreme Court, I forget what state it was, you've probably seen it, where they're putting that chip in their hand to get in their company. They wave it in front and they get in the door of the company. Well, Supreme Court put a stop to that, and here's the only reason why they did it, Dave, is they've let tattoo artists put that chip in there, and because the skin healed over the device, it was considered a surgery.
Sure.
And they said, no more of that. The doctor has to do it. The company said, well, we're going to stop that and the rest of the companies because that's too expensive.
I think it's like
to have this done. But you better believe, though, Dave, that there's going to be somebody trying to figure out a way around that.
Well, it's what it is if you're in the medical field, they put it in the webbing of the hand between the index finger and the thumb. What it is,
right,
is it's like a 14-gauge trocar, which is a large needle. And then if anybody's ever donated blood, they use a 16-gauge needle, which is about the size of a pencil lead. And it's, the reason it's that big is because they don't want to rupture the cells as they come out of your veins into the, you know, catching it in the little bag that wobbles back and forth to keep it from clotting. Well, this thing is a gauge bigger. It's a 14 gauge.
It's huge.
And they take that and push it into your skin, underneath the skin, and they push that little capsule-looking thing out and underneath the webbing of your forefinger and your thumb, and that stays there, and it's an RFID, a radio frequency identity diode, or I think that's what it is. Radio.
Yeah, I think you're right.
It's anyway, it emits a signal, and that signal can be picked up if you have the capability to do it.
You can track people with it.
Well, yeah, you can track them. They put them in dogs all the time.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
But you want to be treated like a dog?
Yeah.
Why not take a little time and get your your money out of your pocket and put it in the machine? Right. Don't have people sticking things in your hand.
Well, and you know that. That's a classic example, Dave, of good and evil. If there was no evil, no good, if there wasn't heaven and hell, if there wasn't the devil, and if there wasn't a God, none of this would be going on. It'd be totally unnecessary. All this control would be totally unnecessary, you know. And but it is going on, and I'm going to do you one better than that, Dave. The other day I made a video. I had heard this, and I really didn't believe it. So I started doing an investigation. Now, folks, and you may know some little something about this. It's called HEK-293. What is that? That's a flavoring that some companies put into your food, and it's disguised under natural flavor, also as artificial flavor, and it is manufactured by Cinemix Company. Now, what is Cinemix? What is Cinemix Company? Cinemix Company is a chemical company, a lab company. I don't know the proper, it's the laboratory, I guess, but it's a company that takes cell tissues, David, from aborted babies, from their kidneys. They manipulate these cells and they produce a product called HEK293. And it's a byproduct of these kidney cells. And it's put in food. It's put, now, the first information I got that PepsiCo used this. And it's a flavoring. And I called PepsiCo and I done it live on Facebook. I called PepsiCo and talked to one of their representatives. Okay, and they said, yeah, at one time we had talks with Cinemix. He said, but we dropped that. We never did follow through with it. But they did own up to having conferences with them about this HEK293. And I asked the man two or three times, and I asked it different ways to keep him from manipulating his answer. I asked him two or three different ways. Did you ever use this HEK293 derived from the cells of kidneys from aborted babies? And he denied it. He said no. He said we never did follow through with Cinemix. Now the video I made, I called them live on Facebook. It is on my Facebook timeline, so folks, you can look that up. But now, I never got a hold of Kraft is supposed to use this. Nestle's is supposed to use this. And Cadbury, which is a British company, they're supposed to.
I think they were bought by Nestle's.
Was they bought by Nestle's?
Yeah, I don't think it's a British company anymore.
Okay. Now, these companies are supposed to be using that. I haven't called them. But PepsiCo, you know, Pepsi, they got a whole...
What's this stuff taste like?
Well, it's natural flavoring.
What's it taste like?
Well, I don't know.
Well, what's it for?
Well, it's artificial flavoring in foods. To enhance... The foods are so processed that a lot of your foods don't have no flavor at all.
I mean, what...
And when
what
they put this in there, it gives them a flavor.
What? I mean, it has to have a taste of something.
Well, I'm sure it does.
Well, what do they...
I've never eaten it raw. I don't know.
Did they put it in?
They put it in cereal. They put it in pop. They put it in noodles. They put it in their cheese. They put it in everything that company practically produces that the process takes the taste out of it. They put it in those foods. And like I said, now, folks, I'm putting this information out there for you. You call Kraft. You call Nestle's. And find out for yourself. Like I said, I haven't called Kraft or Nestle's, but, and you know...
Where did you hear about this stuff at?
I just run across it on the internet, Dave.
Whose website was it?
There's all kinds. Go on YouTube and you'll get all kinds of them.
I've never heard of it myself.
Yeah, go on YouTube or Google Cinemix Company. Okay, but they... And it's a fact, as a matter of fact, a judge brought it up in a lawsuit in Alabama where a woman sued a doctor for killing her baby. And to where he verified, that might not have been the case. Hold that thought, folks. I've got a mountain of papers here. But a judge brought that up in a lawsuit. That and No, what that was, Dave, was Planned Parenthood sued these people for making these undercover tapes, and Planned Parenthood tried to say that these videos was tampered with, and they sued this boy and girl that made these tapes. Veritas, I think, was the name of the boys' company.
Yeah, I've heard of them.
That judge come back with his findings from film forensic experts. They had not been tampered with. They had videos to where Planned Parenthood owned up on live video that they did sell those body parts. Now, how is it legal for Cinemix to get those kidneys? There is a loophole or something gone wrong to where these aborted babies, folks, are worth millions and millions of dollars to these companies. And as a matter of fact, Jay Sekulow, I've got that here somewhere too. Right here it is. Jay Sekulow, the abortion industry is getting federal taxpayers' money for the sale of aborted baby parts. Now, you know who Jay Sekulow is with Judicial Watch. Said, we've already exposed and defeat one federal government contract for the body parts of aborted babies. Now, listen to this. The National Institutes of Health signed a federal contract with the University of California at San Francisco to obtain body parts from unborn babies to make at least two humanized mice out of. Now, that's Judicial Watch from Jay Sekulow, and I just got this email yesterday from Judicial Watch, and they're signing a petition, taking up petitions. He's got lawsuits filed on him. Folks, this abortion industry is a multi-billion dollar industry. Companies like Cinemix and other companies, University of California, the laboratories, the National Institute of Health, they're experimenting with these babies. This stuff that Cinemix is doing with these kidney cells from aborted babies, that's a byproduct, this HEK293, David. That's the next thing you can get to cannibalism. And this stuff's got to be stopped, David. And also for you ladies, Neocutis, NEOCUTIS beauty products, and a lot of your vaccines, Dave, they've got them cells in them too. They've got a lot of the same byproducts from these kidney cell stems in them. And there's another thing, FlavoSweet. You ever heard of FlavoSweet?
Hmm.
Artificial sweetener. It's got an S617 in it, derived from aborted babies' organs. Folks, this stuff is so dark. It's this Frankenstein stuff, David. This crap has to be stopped. And you can go on YouTube, verify this. Call Cinemix. They'll probably come out and tell you. And I tell you something else. A couple years ago, David, I called it was shampoo, hand lotion or something. I called that company in California. I had heard through the grapevine this company used aborted baby cells in their product. I called these people. Now, Facebook fans, listen to this. I called these people myself. And you know what? I called that lab, and that woman said yes. Said, yes, sir, we use aborted cells in our product. She was honest with me. I was nice to her and had a little conversation. That was the end of it. And, Dave, this is scary stuff, Buck. If a university wants to take cells and wants to make two human-like mice out of it, where are we headed?
I don't know if you really could do that.
Maybe not, but they're going to give it a try.
I've heard of, what was it they did? They could make, in a petri dish they could grow. It didn't involve mice, but they took human cells and they made a, I think they made an ear and they made a nose and made different parts.
I've seen
by I forget the process how they called it. It's
growing artificial body parts is what they're doing.
It's growing cells and the cells multiply, but they form like a frame which has the shape of an ear or a nose, and they can actually transplant that back onto a human being, without rejection.
Mm-hmm.
But that it didn't involve any animals at all. That's the only thing I've ever seen as far as that kind of research.
They used that person's cells to do that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why your body's not going to reject itself. Okay, I see no problem with that.
Well, they use,
if they use your cells to do it with.
Well, they use, in bone grafts, they use dead people's bones, which they just use the matrix of the bone, but the body, your body naturally fills in with new calcium and new marrow for the bone, in the center part of the bone, but it just uses this like it's a skeleton for
all the cells have actually been
it's dry, freeze dried, sterilized, but it's just used as a matrix for new bone growth. It's in transplants, but I don't know. This stuff is really I was in the medical field 40 years ago, and I don't. 30 years ago, and I don't really remember all. Well, I don't keep up with it that much. What all's going on today, technology wise, because I've been out of it for so many years. But it's advancing.
Well, you look at the technology you was talking about, Dave. That ain't the only technology advancing. You look at this computer. Everything is advancing, and the knowledge is increasing. But a lot of it is used for evil, David. And I'm telling you, these Planned Parenthood is selling body parts to these labs, selling body parts to be experimented with. And there's no telling what they're doing overseas with the aborted babies and organs out of their infanticide people that they kill. Folks, I'm telling you, We need to stand up against this stuff, and if nothing else, slow it down. At least stand up and say, hey, I don't like this. I'm coming against it, you know. And now let's shift gears a little bit, David. Little Willie's girlfriend, Kamala Harris, is running for president. And the owner and CEO of... what's that coffee? Starbucks.
Schultz.
You couldn't hold me down, make me drink a cup of that stuff. He made a statement one time, if you're for a traditional marriage, I don't even want you in my store. He didn't have to worry about that because I wouldn't drink that crap anyway. I wouldn't pay no $3 or $4. I won't pay $2 for a cup of coffee. But now, Kamala Harris, now I dug this up today. This is from a January 23rd article. She was involved in a surveillance cover-up scheme. And in California, new evidence is coming up about that when she was the attorney general there. And she was involved in an illegal operation to surveil phone calls and things. And over 624 wiretaps in 2014, and like 44,000 people's conversation, 44,000 people, and over 2 million conversations were tapped, and there was only 17 wiretap applications that was applied for, I'm waiting for this to come out on her. And but now she's trying to give away the farm, and this guy from Starbucks, I can't think of his name.
His last name, Schultz.
Schultz, yeah. Now he was doing a public deal somewhere, and buddy, the Democrats scared to death of him, And so there's one guy come out on him, shouted him down, and told him not to be running. He's going to give President Trump the election.
Well, it'd be like what happened with Ross Perot and Bill Clinton and George H.W. Bush back in 92. I told everybody, I said, you vote for Perot, and he said, you're voting for Bill Clinton because it's going to give him the presidency. And sure enough, it did happen, and he only got like 46% of the vote. But Bill Clinton never, ever got 50% of the vote in either election, in 92 or 96. I think he was a little bit closer to 50% in 96 when he ran against, what's his name from Kansas? I can't think of his name. But anyway.
I can't either.
Bob something or another. Anyway, he ran against
Bob Dole.
Bob Dole, when he beat Bob Dole, he only beat him by a couple points. He might have 48% of the vote. But Bill Clinton could never have beaten George H.W. Bush if Ross Perot had not been in the race. Because Ross Perot drew off 18-19% of the vote.
Yeah.
And that just, it was mostly Republicans that voted for him.
So that big giant sucking sound with him sucking votes up.
But anyway, the same thing probably would happen this year, or this coming year, 2020, if Schultz ran against as an independent. Well, he's got the money. He's a billionaire.
Oh, yeah.
He could self-finance his own campaign. And that's why the Democrats aren't too happy about that. But he would draw Republican votes too, I'm sure, but not as many as he would
Trumpers,
but not as many as Democrat votes.
Right. I watched a video today on somebody put on Facebook, and the whole video, and it was a couple minutes long, of all the places where President Trump, since he'd been getting paid, been president, quarterly he donates his check. Mm-hmm. And all the different places that he donated his check to. And I put a little comment on, what more do you never Trumpers want? President Trump give a man $10,000 so he could pay, if it was somebody that worked for one of his campaigns and he couldn't pay for his dad's chemo. President Trump gave him, out of his own pocket, $10,000, mm-hmm. just out of his heart, from his heart. And so time went on, and he said that he was going to give that to his dad to help pay for his chemo treatments. So later on, President Trump asked him, said, how much of that money did you give your dad? He said, I give it all to him. When the guy was getting ready to leave his office, he wrote that man another $5,000 check just as a token of his appreciation, of his love for his father. Now, who does that, David? Who sends a private plane? He's seen a little girl with a rare disease. Trump don't brag on this stuff. Nobody knows this but those that are around him, because he don't tell this stuff. He's seen a little girl with a rare disease on one of these TV shows. Okay, the parents never had the money to take her where she needed some kind of special treatment. It's a very, very rare disease. The parents never had the money to fly the little girl to go get this special treatment. He heard about this. He sent his own private jet to pick this little girl up and take her up there for her treatment. And not only that, he found another little person, little boy, little girl with the same disease, and somehow or another, he had a meeting with them too. I mean, the guy's heart is as big as this table, Dave. How much more never Trumpers want? How much more do they want from this guy that has faced opposition before day one, before he was sworn in? They've tried to destroy this man, Dave. And then you got the Karl Marx Party, the Democrats. Folks, let me tell you something. This is not your dad's, your great-grandparents, your grandparents, I should say, Democratic Party, David.
They wouldn't recognize
him. John F. Kennedy, none of them would recognize this Democratic Party that is going on today, David. How can anybody? Now, I'm even-handed here. A lot of the Republicans are no good lying, downright scoundrels. But I tell you what, brother, the platform upholds life, innocent life, and they're not trying to drive us into communism and socialism like the Democratic Party is, and kill all the unborn they can get their hands on the way there, Dave. I've never seen the day like we're living in today where they want to take the greatest nation in this whole wide world and destroy it with its ungodliness. It gets under my skin. I'm trying not to get excited here, but Kamala Harris, Pocahontas, and that little Alexandria Cortez, the lunatic, I call her, they are trying to drive this party just as far to the left, David, as they can. And I think that's why the Starbucks dude stepped in there.
Yeah, he's the only one who's got any sense.
Yeah.
But you know what?
Very little at that, really.
You got to look at why is it that Kim Jong-un and Maduro from Venezuela,
yeah,
they're both fat as hogs, and all the people around them are starving to death.
Right,
you
right.
Worry about that?
Yeah.
Alexia Ocasio-Cortez, what do you think about that? How's that socialism working for you?
Right.
But I saw a fat hog jogging with his soldiers, and he weighs about 300 pounds, look like.
He's eating
that. He got plenty to eat. Everybody else has already ate all the zoo animals, all their pets,
yeah,
everything that they can eat, they've eaten.
Well,
so just ask yourself that question. Why are these leaders of these socialist countries fat,
yeah,
and all the people,
yeah,
are skinny as a rail?
All socialism does is spread the misery. Folks, God bless you. I love you. This is Les Skymona Day from Arm Radio. Dave, we got our hour in, brother. And Jimmy, thank you so much. We love you all. God bless you. Thank you for listening to Arm Radio and Unscheduled. Let's come on to Dave. Take us on out, Brother
revolution,
Jim.
Revolution, gun control, the sound of soul. Shooting rockets to the moon. Kids going up to soon. Politicians say more taxes will solve everything.
And the band plays.